Hello learners, today we'll be learning about planning and organizing part 2, which will include, this will be including meaning and importance of organizing, process of organizing, organization structures, formal and informal organizations, delegation and decentralization. What is organizing? Organizing is the next important function of management after the planning. You know that in case of planning, a manager decides what is to be done in future. In case of organizing, he decides on the ways and means through which it will be easier to achieve what has been planned. Suppose it is planned to start a new plant for soft drinks within 6 months. The immediate task for the manager then is to identify and assign the various tasks involved and devise structure of duties and responsibilities so that things move smoothly and the objective is achieved. All these tasks form part of organizing function. Organizing refers to the process of identifying and grouping the work to be performed, determining detailed rules and regulations of working for individuals and groups in organization, establishing relationship among various job positions and defining and determining responsibility and authority for each job position. Organizing is very important in the sense that it facilitates administration as well as operations of an enterprise. By grouping work and people properly, productivity increases and effectively delegation becomes possible. Organizing facilitates growth and diversification of activities through clear division of work, and it helps in developing a proper organization structure, and the extent and nature of decentralization can be determined. And organizing is very important because it provides for the optimum use of technical and human resources, and it encourages creativity and enhances interaction among different levels of management, which leads to unification of efforts of all. Now we will study process of organizing. It includes 5 steps, which are identification of activities, grouping of activities, then assignment of responsibility, giving authority, and establishing relationship. So first step is identification of activity. Every enterprise is created with a specific purpose. Based on this, activities involved can be identified. Then, for example, in a manufacturing firm, producing goods, selling them are the major activities. In addition to routine activities like paying salary to employees, raising loans from outside, paying taxes to the government, etc. And these activities vary when the organization is a service concern or a trading firm. Therefore, it is essential to identify various activities of an enterprise. The next step is grouping of activities. Once the activities are identified, then they need to be grouped. They are grouped in different ways. For example, grouping all the activities in the form of a department. The activities which are similar in nature can be grouped as one, and a separate department can be created. For example, activities undertaken before sale of a product, during sale of a product, and after the sale of a product can be grouped under the function of marketing department. These become functions of a marketing department, which will include activities before sales, during sales, and after the sales. After this, the third step comes, which is normally, all activities of a manufacturing unit can be grouped into major functions also, like purchasing, production, marketing, accounting, and finance. And each function can be subdivided into specific jobs. The third step comes, which is assignment of responsibility. Having completed the exercise of identifying and grouping and classifying all activities into specific jobs, then those jobs should be assigned to individuals to take care of. When the responsibility is assigned, the proper authority should be given so as to complete the allotted task. On the basis of responsibility given to a specific individual, there are also to be given the necessary authority to ensure effective performance. And the last step in the process is establishing relationship. This is a very important job of management, as everybody in the organization should know as to whom she is to report, thereby establishing a structure of relationship. By doing so, relationship become clear and delegation is facilitated. After studying process, we'll study organization structure. It is the process of organization culminates into an organization structure which constitutes a network of job positions and the authority relationships among the various positions. The various factors that are usually taken into consideration for designing a good organization structure are job specification, departmentation, and authority responsibility relationship. The whole structure takes the shape of a pyramid and broadly indicates the task assigned, the hierarchical relationship, and the pattern of communication and coordination. Based on the arrangement of activities, two most commonly used forms of organization structure are functional structure and divisional structure. Functional structure is an organization structure formed by grouping together all activities into functional departments and putting each department under one coordinating head is called functional structure. Thus, in an industrial enterprise, the functions like manufacturing, marketing, finance, and personnel may constitute the major separate units or departments of the enterprise. In case of a large retail store, purchasing, sales, and warehousing may be the major units. It may be noted that the major units are further divided into subunits. For example, the manufacturing department may be subdivided into stores, repairs, maintenance, production, etc. Thus, in any industrial enterprise, the functions like manufacturing, marketing, finance, personnel may constitute the major separate units or departments of enterprise, and in case of a large retail store, purchasing, sales, warehousing may be the major units, and there are subunits. So, look at the example. This becomes a hierarchical structure where top management further delegates the authority and responsibility to the middle level management, and then they delegate their authority and responsibility to further lower level management. Then comes divisional structure. In large organizations dealing in multiple products and serving a number of distinctive markets, the divisional structure is considered more suitable. Under such structure, the organization is divided into units entrusted with all activities related to different products on different territories. Each divisional head is required to look after all functions related to the product or market territory. For example, the owner or the president is looking after two regions, region 1, region 2, and both the regions having their own marketing, operations, and finance department. There are two types of organizations, formal organizations and informal organizations. Formal organization refers to the officially established pattern of relationships among departments, divisions, and individuals to achieve well-defined goals, and is a consciously designed structure of roles. In other words, formal organization clearly spells what a person has to do, from who he has to take orders, and what rules, policies, and work procedures are to be followed. Thus, it is a system of well-defined jobs, each bearing a definite measure of authority, responsibility, and accountability. This promotes order and facilitates planning and controlling functions. On the counterpart, informal organizations refer to the relationship between individuals in the organization based on personal attitudes, likes and dislikes, and originates to meet their social and emotional needs and develops spontaneously. It represents natural grouping of people in work situation and is supplementary to formal organization as it serves the needs not satisfied by formal organization. The formal organization does not provide opportunity to members to exchange personal views and experiences, so they interact informally to fulfill such interests and needs. In fact, informal organization comes into being because of the limitations of the formal structure. Both are interlinked. However, they differ in respect of their origin, purpose, structure, authority, channel of communication, and behavior of members. The next we'll study, delegation. Delegation is process of entrustment of a part of work or responsibility and authority to another, and the creation of accountability for performance is known as delegation. There are three major elements of delegation, which are assignment of responsibility. This is also known as entrustment of duties. Duties can be divided into two parts. One part that the individual can perform himself, and the other part that he can assign to his subordinates to perform. Second element is granting authority. Authority refers to the official powers and position required to carry on any task. When duties are assigned to subordinates, then the required authority must also be conferred to him. For example, when a manager asks his subordinate to receive a guest of the company on his behalf, then he must also grant him some authority, like carry the company vehicle, booking the company guest house for accommodation, etc. And the third important element is creating accountability. This refers to the obligation on the part of the subordinate to whom responsibility and authority are granted to see to it that the work is done. In other words, the delegatee, the person to whom, authority is delegated, is fully answerable to his superior for performance of the task assigned to him. Thus, the superior ensures performance through accountability by his subordinates. Delegation is considered as one of the most important elements in the process of organization because it reduces the load on managers as work is successfully shared by the subordinates. It is very important as it improves the managerial effectiveness because by delegating a good part of the work to the subordinate, the managers are able to concentrate on important matters which requires personal attention. Next, we'll study decentralization. Decentralization refers to a systematic effort to delegate authority at all levels of management and in all departments. This shifts the power of decision making to lower level under a well-considered plan. Take the case of traffic police controlling movement of vehicles on road. The traffic controller, he holds a lower level position in the organization, yet he has a lot of authority given to him. The senior people, they concentrate on the ways and means to improve traffic control. In case of business units also, the heads of the department have the authority to take decisions on most matters relating to the functioning of their department. The top managers are confined themselves. Repeat, the top managers confine themselves to policy decisions like product lines to be added, further investment, etc. Whatever plans or whatever responsibility is delegated by head of the departments to their subordinate, they execute it. Decentralization is very important for any organization as it promotes initiative and creativity. It also helps employees to take quick and appropriate decisions. It reduces the workload of the top level management. It motivates the employees and gives them more autonomy. And in this process, the top management is freed from the routine jobs. It enables them to concentrate on crucial areas and plan for growth. Now we'll look into the difference between delegation and decentralization. Delegation is the process of assigning responsibility and authority and thereby creating accountability, whereas decentralization is the ultimate outcome of planned delegation. The another difference is delegation of authority takes place between the manager and his subordinates, but decentralization involves the entire organization and is between top management and various divisions or departments. The next difference is delegation is done to speed up the work and is essential in trace. Decentralization is optional and is usually done in large-scale organizations. Last but not the least, in case of delegation, the responsibility and authority delegated may be withdrawn by the delegator, whereas this is not easy in case of decentralization. We have learnt about process of organization, organization structure, formal and informal organization, delegation, and decentralization. Thank you, learners.